Any program in the ashram going on today?
Yes. What kind of program?
No, program, program.
Program. Yes, it is a yajna.
Jagna.
No, it's, I think it's don't stop. Because the evening yesterday, I heard that chanting.
It is supposed to be 24 hours a day. No?
In the morning, as usual, after that,
no, I'm curious because nobody came today.
No, today it was as usual, judgment.
People are supposed to put their desires in the fire, but then go and ask for the fire for more things. You know what I'm trying to say? So people, not the people that perform the, not the people that perform the rituals. Maybe they can play with the ball, not sure. See, not the people that perform the rituals, but. People, instead of giving up the desires, see, for what they want, they go and ask for more than what they want. You understand? Instead of saying, "My God, I give you all my desires," they say, "My God, give me more than what I want." Tendencies, right? I want, I don't want. I like, I don't like. Right? Well, this is what you remember. See? Memories. Means good memories, bad memories. So you have to give up good memories and bad memories. Right? This is the past that tries to reincarnate. See? Means trying to become materialized, see? To become matter again. See? So the past tries to reincarnate in the present, in human form. This is the meaning of reincarnation. Then this is reincarnate. And for that, they need a human body to be satisfied. If these tendencies are not given up, then the body will carry on, see, going here and there. See, poor body, right? Going here and there to get something that it doesn't need. So if the mind is still, the body is also still. See? If the mind doesn't go anywhere, the body doesn't go anywhere either. And if it goes somewhere, it's just to get what it needs, right? Or to get the money to get what the body needs. That's all. To work, whether it's at the office or in the farm. So you will have to do something for the survival of the body, right? Either to work in an office and get some money, go to the shop and buy the food, or to raise your hand, pick a banana and eat, otherwise the body dies. Right? So these are the only activities that are really necessary. The minimum for the survival of the body. And the enlightened being is the example, right? He's not interested in anything. And you see them only walking around to get for their survival, and then they sit down and keep quiet. Or maybe some entertainment, some games, you know, why not? But these are called sports, hobbies. And unfortunately, now there is also competition. It's not even playing for the sake of fun, but playing for the sake of winning, right? Any questions? Questions to them? Can I ask you food? Can you go to my house and ask Nastya to give you my bottle of water? Yes. Yes, ask Nastya to give you my water bottle. Huh? It's not here, no? I didn't bring it. Such a cool girl. Your mind not comes. A leg not comes. Anybody there? Any question from there? Annie? Today is Saturday, right? Today is Saturday. No questions? No questions? Imbalance.
Yes.
Imbalance.
Yes.
Ah.
but every morning and evening, because I lost it. And when I
let me see if I understood. You come to satsang and the mind is balanced.
Yes.
So when you go to sleep and when you wake up, the mind is still balanced.
Yes.
Right?
And there is I can feel that satsang is very useful. But yesterday I started to think maybe I can't keep balance without satsang because I am waiting for it. It's like a reflex now.
I came here and everything is okay, and I'm a little afraid to be without.
It's like a
passion, maybe. No? See, whether you are here or there, you have to be in satsang. See? Means associated with the self. So there is not a thing as too much satsang, whether you are collectively or individually in satsang. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, but when I'm alone, it is more difficult for me.
What to do? This is a collective feedback. That when they come here, when we are together, somehow it is easier, right? Or automatically the mind keeps quiet, or... This is why satsang is recommended, right? Because the mind is quiet, and then the mind gets balanced in its place of origin, right? Gets balanced, means not too active, not too pure, not too dull. You can even see how the three characteristics of the mind, see, moves while you are in satsang. It's like a frequency of energy. Right? And the mind is getting balanced, right? In satsang, in sat, in the self. In silence. When the mind is in silence, right? It's always in silence, even if it is not. So when so when the mind is in silence, see, the three characteristics of the mind, see, get balanced. When you go to sleep, right? And then the mind says, woo-hoo, party time, right? There's dream about so many things, right? And the mind doesn't even know what it's doing by producing this dream. It's exhausting itself because the dream is that. See? It's a vibescape. It's an exhaustion place, see, where all the desires, unfulfilled desires, all this stuff, right? And you see yourself in your dreams traveling here and doing that, and see, all this is what you wanted to do that you couldn't do, not you, but the mind, right? And then try to do it elsewhere, right? And creates an imaginary, a parallel world, see, which is a dream state. And it's playing guitar and giving concerts in the dreams and stuff. Right? And then the mind wakes up very quickly, takes over, overpowers, right? And so it does it at the end and at the beginning, because in the meantime it's more difficult because what? Because you come to satsang, right? This is why the ego doesn't like to come to satsang. No, I have to be active, I have to do something. I need to, you know. What to do? Doing what anyway? My teacher used to laugh when say, "Why you didn't come to satsang?" I was busy. I said, "Busy doing what? Are you in your country? Any responsibilities, any duties that you have to go to the office or something? What were you doing here? You come here to do nothing, right? Aren't you tired of?" And then keep the mind active, listening to these talks, reading books about these topics. right? Singing bhajan. So if there is an activity to perform here, it's all focused on this matter, this subject. Thinking of God. Are they thinking of God or not thinking at all? One of the two, right? This is a job of the spiritual seeker. The rest is just to feed the monkey with banana so he can keep on, see, so the sadhana can carry on, right? Because the body is necessary. I was busy, he will laugh. Doing what? See, talking here and there. Going to this entertainment, to this show, to these things.
If I were able to do something, I would not do it.
I don't know, it depends on what do you want to do. Exactly. Right? So your mind is very rajasic. The body needs some activity, see, because otherwise it becomes stiff while you are here, right? Then you go for a walk or something, right? Maybe some stretching, some yoga, whatever, why not? The body needs some movement, right? I was very busy doing it. Or the mind says, I need a break from spirituality. The ego says, I need some holiday. Holiday. It's too much. Once a day is enough, twice is too much. See? See, the rock salt says, no, I will go to the ocean a little bit because I'm busy, I have to do something else. Right? Why? Because it's the rock salt, see, stays in the water, inside the water it disappears, right? What do you mean? Naturally, maybe you are not destined to be here, and then even if you are destined to be here, you have to do something for your survival, right? Then if she's destined to be here, she may have to do some shooting, she may do some salsa dance in Bangalore, maybe in the future, who knows, or whatever, right? So, even I have to justify the donation, right? And then I have to work, right? So I come to the office in the morning and I come to the office in the afternoon. I need to justify, right, my salary, isn't it? Otherwise my boss will get angry with me because I'm giving you a salary and you are not working enough. Good memories, bad memories, right? And there is a tendency to do something to repeat them or to avoid them, right? That's all. This is what has to be destroyed. Not a practical mind for the survival of the body, for whatever it is, right? If she's an actress, then she has to read the lines, right? Has to memorize them, stand in front of a mirror, act, see, to see if she's doing it properly. Then this is the work, they call it, it's a practical mind, right? This is the mind as your practical tool for fulfill your duties in daily life, right? The other one is mind as ego, see, mind as a separate entity, as a self. The mind, yeah, goes here, fantasies, right? Isn't it? And what happens when you see that? It is stopped, isn't it? Isn't it? Right? This is awakening, right? You wake up. You are not dreaming all this. How old are you? How old?
11.
It's called the vagaries of the mind. See? Vagaries. Mind is wandering, see? In the past. It's all about the past or about the future. And it's trying to project the past into the future. It's thinking, how can I repeat in the future what I experienced in the past? See? And it's using the present for that purpose. Such a waste of time. it's using the present to dream. And by dreaming, it does nothing. It's just thinking. Right? I'm thinking in doing something, right? Tomorrow I'll do it. Tomorrow I'll stop smoking, see? Tomorrow I will stop thinking, see? Tomorrow I will practice tomorrow, see? In the afternoon or in 5 minutes. I'm doing it. This is tamasic. Tamasic means postponing, see? Postponing, laziness. See? Rajasic means accelerating. I want it, not tomorrow, I want it now, right? I want all now, give me all now. I want to know everything now, I want to all the money now. See, I don't want to wait for 3 months to get to, right? And the mind goes from tamas to rajas, see, from dullness to activity, and never stops in purity, see, jumps over purity. Even purity has to be left behind. So purity leaves you to that which is neither pure nor impure, right? So pure mind leads you to no mind, and no mind leads you to self-knowledge. There is no other way. And then stay like that. Come, ask. Ask.
If it goes like this, where?
How is it? How can I understand it?
No.
If it goes like this, I don't understand. You translate, you can translate. Trividi Pajalasta. Paruski Gavari and Trividi Pajalasta. Da. She's Wonder Woman. She has a wonderful mind. Wonderful mind. A mind full of wonder. I wonder. Wonder Woman. Wonder mind. So what is the question?
Okay, but then it's easy to notice that it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
And when I'm not here,
yes.
Couldn't. So
see, you have to carry on coming here until you can do, see, what happens here. See, you have to come here to learn, to understand that you are witnessing the mind and you are that which is witnessing the mind, right? Here becomes easy to realize that you are that which is witnessing the mind, right? That's the whole purpose of coming to sansa, right? So something happens here, right, that makes it is called grace, the grace of the guru, but not Caesar. Caesar is not the guru, see? The guru is the self. So by the grace of the self, right, then the mind keeps quiet. Not Caesar. Caesar is self. It's like at this body, no difference. Eventually, when you realize more and more that you are that which is witnessing, then you don't have to come here again, right? Whatever you are, you remain as the witnessing being, self, that you are, right? Then, even you can go by yourself through the process of dissolution of the mind, right? Without having to come to self-centered, right? You can go back to your country, you can get married with the blueprints, right? You can have beautiful children, etc. And then you can see, no need to any. Like Jesus said, once we see the Father, we don't need to see any other priest. See? And the priest didn't like that, and they crucified him. See? Because now, because of you, I will lose my job. See? Right? And you come and spoil my business. Right? Jesus had a pure mind, pure heart. And sometimes when you read pure heart, means pure mind. It's not talking about the heart as consciousness, right? And this is what Jesus said, only through me you reach the Father. So people didn't understand. Through me means through pure mind, you can reach the divine, right? You don't reach the divine. See, you never left the divine. You are the divine itself, right? This is just a way of speech. And this was a stage of Jesus Christ also, see? Even Jesus goes through the three stages of understanding. Not realization, but understanding. The ultimate was, the last statement was the ultimate understanding, which is not understanding, but realization. First, I am the son, the messenger of God, right? Then, I am the son of God. Then I am God. Right? Oh, my father and I are one. Right? So the body mind is not a separate entity. See? They are one. The body and the mind are one. See? With God. But then also that disappears. See? Because we need two. One that is one with the other. Right? I am God, see, not even one is God, but I am God itself. Huh? Because that is the identity with the body. I am an instrument. See, identity with the mind, I'm part of God. See, when there is no identity with the body and the mind, I am God. So Astra also, I am coming from the light is within me, I am the light. Hanuman, right? When I identify myself with the body, I feel I am your instrument. When I identify myself with the mind, I feel I am part of you. When I don't identify myself with the body and the mind, I am you. Right? Three stages. One is called duality, the other one is relative duality, and the other one is absolute non-duality. Chamana banana. Chamana banana. Banana. Yeah.
This stage.
What do you mean?
Where are you?
Exactly. What am I doing wrong? Buddha, all of them, see, went through the same process. Even the avatars, they go through some sort of physical phenomenon and it says, okay, hindrance is gone, they say, right? Let's do my job. Even Rama, isn't it? Appears to be going through hindrance, right? What can you and I expect? Like this. magic enlightened pill. Take it and it's over. Even the body can slowly recover its, if the body has enough time to live, even the physical condition can go back to normal. And if it doesn't, it doesn't bother you. It doesn't affect you. After self-inquiry,
yes, it immediately appears like the second head, which you see that, okay, I did it.
Yes, it's like a second self, right? See, when this individual self disappears, there is just, you call it second self, right? But this is not the second self, it's the only self. It's the only one self, right? So when the inquiry dissolves, what you think you are. See, what you think you are merges into what you really are, into what you really are. And you realize to be that. See, that self. The body still is there, the mind may operate for practical purposes, but the identity is not there. Right?
So it can come back
bigger and say, oh. Exactly. The ego comes back. Right? If you see the ego coming back, the ego goes back again to its place of being. See? That's it. You destroy the ego there and then, see, in its very place of origin. See? As it arises, see, it's destroyed. Means it's pushed back. Remember the snake? You look at the snake, and the snake goes back to the cave, right? To the whole. In Russian.
По-русски
говорю.
То, что вообще как-то проснились, понятно, какие-то встречи, какие-то инфекции, наоборот, такое спокойнее, как-то очень, очень избирательно. Ну, просто я не могу, не знаю, что с этим можно. Очень, ну, странно. I don't know how much I need to sleep.
Forget about that. See, you don't sleep, you don't dream, you don't wake up. The mind is dreams, the waking state and deep sleep. You don't wake up, you don't sleep. You always are. See? You are witnessing the three state of mind, right? I have the same problem, see, you lose, see, time, space, all that goes away because it doesn't exist, right? It exists relatively, it has relative existence, it doesn't have absolute existence. When the mind comes into existence, then time and space and the rest of it comes into existence. Where is time and space and the rest of it in deep sleep? So I have the same problem. You close your eyes and you can't sleep. And yet there are no dreams, or sometimes you don't feel the body. Because you see, when the identity with the mind disappears, right? And then you are conscious of being all the time. This is something that you have to get used to, right? When the veil of ignorance, which is identity, disappears, then you are conscious of being all the time. You are witnessing all the time, even deep sleep. See? There is no identity with deep sleep. So the idea, I am sleeping, means I am the mind, right? Disappears. At the beginning is something weird, right? Strange, new. Eventually it becomes normal. You get used to it. See? This is why people say you cannot understand a jnani, you cannot understand an enlightened being. It's impossible. Right? Even if he explains very much these words, you cannot understand it. You have to experience it. You have to become one. See, one jnani. You have to become self-realized. Then you understand. Otherwise, you think you understand. You believe. See? So some knowledge is given to you naturally. Some practice also has to be there. I had this funny phenomenon, see. I was very tired. See, my eyes were very tired, especially the eyes. See. And then I would go to bed. And I couldn't sleep. Right? And then. And I can't sleep. But the mind was quiet. See, very quiet. See, sometimes hardly feeling the body or not feeling the body. This is like a samadhi. See, you lose body consciousness, you lose mind consciousness, but still you are conscious of being. Yeah? And then you get tired trying to sleep. Trying to rest, you get tired. Right? Because you are thinking. And then. For example, at night, see, yesterday night, when I give the night satsang, at that time already the eyes are tired, and I just close my eyes. See? And the body is resting, and still I'm going. See? Who is going? See? Who is speaking? Caesar is speaking. Caesar is basically half asleep, half awake. You get used to that. You have to get used to that. You will get used to that. What you are does not wake up, does not sleep. See, it's not coming, it's not going, it's ever present. See, you cannot not be. See, and you cannot not be what you already are. And you will swim between identity with what you really are and identity with what you think you are not, right? Until you realize that what you are and what you are not all together is what you are. I don't know if I'm making any sense, but when you realize that real and unreal are one, see, the permanent and the impermanent are one, see, then who is who, where is where, what is what, then you forget it all. See, there is a moment when you forget everything. See? And then, right? The next question is, what to do with this? Then this came into existence for some reason, right? And this is going to happen. Then you also leave the body alone. See, but there is no because you like to do something. Or because you want to do something, right? Because the body has no choice, right? But to fulfill its purpose, right? See, so the activities of the body are no longer controlled by I want, I don't want, I like, I don't like. Rajasic mind, active mind, is looking for experiences. See, we want to go to new places, to meet new people, right? New food, a new kind of, oh, exotic. Let's go to India to try exotic food, right? Now let's go to Thailand to try a different exotic food. And let's go to Brazil to experience an exotic environment, right? And if it is not something material, it's intellectual. I want to know more. Let's read these books. Let's read about Julio Verne. Let's read the Vedas. Read more, more. Right? This is rajasic mind. Right? It's looking for something, whether it is material or intellectual. Right? Whether it is physical or subtle. Right? Dullness is, I don't want to go there. I don't want to do that. See? I just want to sleep. Right? Tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow. See? No, satsang today, no. And today I will have a break. I'll come tomorrow. Right? Or we have to clean the house, we have to do shopping. No, tomorrow. And then, day after tomorrow, you are sleeping in a big house. Right? And all the job gets delayed. And then you have to do it now fast. And then you go from dullness to activity. Oh my God, I have to clean because, right? And then you go, you're driving yourself crazy, see? Controlled by these two characteristics of the mind. Purity, I have to help the humanity, I have to serve this, I have to. Also, it is mind, right? And there is identity with it, right? Once you realize yourself, see, the pure mind gets activated by itself when it is necessary, right? And there is no identity with it. You don't think that you are good, see, that you are pure, that you are helping others, that you are serving God. See, the action, the pure mind expresses itself, right? See, it uses the body for that purpose, and there is no identity with it. And dullness and activity is just reduced to its minimum. Right? I noticed that. See? Basically, what is more tired at the end of the day for me are the eyes, not even the rest of the body. I found that the rest of the body still is have energy, still is strong, you see. It's not need even to have the eyes. Right? Because the eyes gets tired of, you see, the sense organ gets tired of perceiving so much objects, right? So the sense organ needs also some rest. See? And in my case, you will notice that the eyes are the one that, then you shoot them down. You see, my God, I can't sleep. Right? Sometimes I can even hear my body snoring. Snoring. Huh? And I can hear even my girlfriend, my wife, she's because I told her, if you hear me snoring, right, wake me up and ask me to go sideways. And then I would stop. Right? Because well, sometimes the neck is like this, disappear. Right? And if you go sideways, you don't. And I can hear my body snoring, and I can hear Nastya saying, Caesar, what? You're snoring. And then, but I am not sleeping, see? I am aware, because I am awareness, right? So all this phenomenon, see, so-called process of dissolution, this is the process of dissolution of the ego, means the process of dissolution of the identity with the body. You have a moment of no identity, right? There's a moment when there is no identity, right? But the tendency to identify yourself with the body comes back. Due to what? Due to the tendencies of the mind. And then the mind says, oh, I'm bored, right? What am I doing in Puttaparthi? Say, wasting my life. I'm doing nothing. See, when I can be in Australia, see, going to the coral reef barrier and swimming with beautiful fishes and doing all this stuff, see, I better go. Right? And then you go from dullness, I'm bored. See, and then you go and jump and start doing, see, all sorts of unnecessary things. So all that takes time to get dissolved, see. I think it's called Manolaya, Manonasa. See, I know these two words. I know which, I don't remember which one really means what. One is the temporary dissolution, the temporary disappearance of the mind. See? And the other one is the permanent disappearance of the mind. See? So first you have like a moment of clarity. See, the mind keeps quiet. I am that. You see what you say, I am that, right? And then you develop what? An alter ego, isn't it? An enlightened ego. Oh my God. Now you are thinking about that. Now you think you are that. Thinking that you are that, you forget you are that. You know what I'm saying? This is why all the master says, do not share your spiritual experiences with anyone. Means, I realize the self, I know I am that, because by doing so, even by thinking in that way, the knowledge of I am that is gone. Now you think you are the self. You are still are the self, right? But you are not aware of it. You are also aware of the thought, I am the self, right? Then when you see the enlightened one, like Buddha, kill him, see? Who understood what? Who realized what? Who is the self? Is the mind saying, I am the self? Right? And it is natural, right? You are doing nothing wrong, right? It is part of the process, see? And these are traps that comes after even awakening, right? And some guidance is necessary even then. When you are fully convinced of your reality, right? Fully convinced, see, capable to be self-aware by yourself, then nice to meet you, Dajjal. It was a pleasure to have you around. Cheers and goodbye. Good luck with the rest of your life. See, send me an email, right? You now and then to say, hi, how are you? That's all, right? We were chasing Mr. Ratan Lal. See, we used to go every day to the garden to see he was giving satsang, right? Because it was not announced publicly, right? And we were not, at that time, some of us, we were not close to him. And then we would never get the news when they were going to be satsang translating for another country. So I myself will go every day to the garden to see he was giving satsang to someone else, right? Yeah, we'll go to the lecture hall when it was a formal one, and I will go every time just chasing to see if there was such. I was thirsty for that. When he saw this real journey for liberation, then he will tell to somebody, if you see Caesar, tell him that tomorrow we have satsang with the Germans. If you see Caesar, tell him we will satsang with the Italians. Then I will go. Right? And I was lucky, I was always lucky to see close. Somehow I will. So yesterday, maybe this boy took it in the wrong context, see, or like he thought I was trying to tell him something, right? bad or wrong. No, just try to make him become aware, right? He comes here and he starts vomiting in a piece of paper or what he's thinking, right? And sorry for the word, he's basically creating all that nonsense and put it in a piece of paper. And then unfortunately somebody has to read that later on as a book. Right? And then he's not interested in what I'm talking about, he's interested in what I'm thinking. So he's more interested in the question, in the doubts, than in the clarification, in the answers, right? So my job is to make you become aware of what you cannot. See, when you can become aware of your own stuff, then my job is done. My job, I have to say something, right? Put it in one word or another. But they don't like it, see? Because I know. No, I know. I've read so many books, and I even came with my guru here. Did you see him? Tell him to come this evening. Or on Monday. He's serious, right? But if you ask me, he's misguided. See? He's not in good company. See? He's misguided. Nobody, why the ashram doesn't want foreigners speaking in the ashram? Because they are all nuts. And they are teaching you their own confusion. Right? And then you pay, you come from Colombia. How much is the ticket? Very expensive ticket. Right? You come to India. This is not the most comfortable place for us. We are not used to this environment. Right? Right? And then you make such an investment in money, time, energy, for a not case in the ashram to mislead you with misinterpreted teachings, right? So these are mechanisms, see, decisions, radical decision that needs to be taken, see, to protect the mental integrity of the devotees. Because in the ashram, so many gurus are there. See? It's difficult to find one seeker. Most of them are gurus already, right? You see them, most of them talking, practicing, rarely. Rarely you see somebody there, see? Quiet, meditating, right? Inquiring. Even after awakening, I went on and on and on, singing bhajans. Right? It was even more beautiful there. The feeling was different, the energy was different than before. Eventually it stopped. Right? I will do it if you ask me to, if you want to know, I may teach you. I will do it just for that, right? To teach you, right? And to explain you. But there is a moment that you don't need. See, you do it basically for the sake of the others, right? Of the seekers, others. They are not others, but no, it's a way of speech. I was there listening to Mr. Ratan Lal sharing with us, see, how to do all these practices according to how Baba taught him, right? Whether it was bhajans or mantras or japa or inquiry or meditation or whatever it was. See, all that, I was not interested because it was not for me, right? But I listened to that and I just practiced it because I said, how can I teach this Even if I don't need the practice, I will do it to see to manage how to do it, so I can explain this to someone, right? Earlier, yesterday night, Caesar, what's wrong with you? You were singing bhajans yesterday night on the hill and repeating mantras. No, there was a question, and I was explained. Oh, I thought you were. I said, what happens to Caesar? What happened to you? You normally don't do it. No, I don't. But if somebody asks me, so I can explain. Nikiko, what's the matter? Yeah.
It's
your habit. It's a habit, right?
Yes.
Mechanic. Mind. It's the mind, not the body, the mind. Well, mind and body are one, but it's basically controlled by a tendency. A tendency. Japanese, right?
Yes.
They don't stop, they don't stop, they do like this. I told you, no, you remind me so much a Japanese friend who used to come to satsang. He was into Zen meditation.
Zen meditation, yes.
Yes, he was very much attached to that. And Mr. Ratanal used to tease him, say, Buddha. They would look at him and say, Buddha. His name was like a very lovely, such a good friend. See, I wonder where is he now, how is he? I hope he's fine wherever he is. And he used to teach him Buddha, and he would. It's like a motor. No, man. He was a doctor, acupuncturist. Young man at that time. We were all young men at that time. Now, see, white hair, what to do? React. He was teasing us to see there was some ego left. Eventually we'll. Tasha. Tasha is Alexander, right? Mm-hmm. Sasha, Alexander, Samadhi, Sudhanda. Sasha, Alexander, Samadhi, Sudhanda.
I try.
Stop trying. You're trying too hard. Relax. You brought this from previous life. See, you're attached to austerities. See? You are very much living like a tapiasi. Tapiasi. Tapiasi is the one that performs tapas. Best tapas is for Giritron. Material knowledge is spiritual knowledge. Forget it all. This is what you surrender. What you know. Because what you know is what you believe that you are. You are not what you know. This is not true self-knowledge. This is not true self-knowledge. Self-knowledge doesn't know anything. Self only knows itself, it doesn't know anything else. This is Socrates' teachings. I know that I know nothing. He knew he was a self, and the self doesn't know anything apart from itself. He doesn't need to know because it is intelligent and intelligence itself. And if knowledge is necessary, it will bring the knowledge out of itself. Maybe she's from Venus, and people from Venus speak like that. Come on, say something. Yes, you, but not mentally, but see, by being yourself. See, by being yourself, see, you inquire about this self as is pretending to be you. See? Who is this I that tells me that I am this body? That tells me that my reality is limited to this body. Who is this one? Telling me that my reality is limited to a particular name and form. This is the self that you are inquiring about. See? Because the ego is present, and then the ego begins the inquiry. Right? And then, yes, I'm progressing, right? I'm doing very good. See? I'm an advanced seeker. An advanced soul. See? Advanced meditator. And then your ego changes its forms, turns into pride. And then pride becomes arrogance. And then from that arrogance comes aggressive and violence. It's called religious violence. See, passive aggressiveness. I know, and I'm telling you, right? Why? Because I'm enlightened being and I know. This is spiritual ego. Based either in intellectual knowledge, or a glimpse of reality. You're literally opening your eyes. I can see everything. You're just beginning to open your eyes. And then these people like this start teaching and preaching, and they are still, see, blinded, not fully, the eyes are not fully open. My teacher warned me of that. My teacher gave me a warning about that trap. He said, you reach the top of the mountain very quickly. Quicker than many others, he said. But it is only when you know the mountain, see? As the palm of your hand, and you're seated comfortably on top of it. Right? Then you can tell people how to get there. So you come this way. You come this way. No, I want to go with Sasha. No, Sasha has a different way. You have to come this way. Sasha, I go this way, you go this way. Sasha. You this way. You better go away. When most of these people are teaching their way, see, they haven't get there, they are on the way and they are teaching their way and say, my way is the only way. Service is the way. You have to do seva. Come and work in the canteen. Right? And all the ways leads in self-inquiry. Why? Because the one that is following the path is the ego. The seeker is the ego, right? And then how can the ego be destroyed like that? I am practicing. Good practice. This is to purify the ego. Eventually, see, the question must be there, right? Who is the practicer? Who is the seeker? Say, who is this I? Who is progressing? Me. I am closer to God than you. I am closer to God than you. Because you repeat only your mantra 108 times. I did it 1008 times, so I am closer. See, as soon as you notice it, see, it stops and you laugh about it, right? As soon as you see the tendency, you stop following it, right? See, you become conscious of something, you don't repeat that something, right? If you really become conscious of it. But if you have only a superficial look on that something, then that something overpowers again. See, this tendency is not destroyed fully. Whatever the tendency may be. So many times somebody says just like this, right? So then it's an identity with that particular form of expression, see, that tendency, that pattern of behavior, right? If there is no identity with it, the awakened one will do it, right? But there is no identity with it. It does it because it lives in the society and then it goes along with the norms of the society. That's all. And he's gone. Where is his sleepiness? He's gone. Right? He's gone. You see? You notice it, he's gone. Because it's not necessary. The word is not asking for anything. It's just the mind tries to. See, there is bliss in a state, but you are not conscious of it. See? That's the closest experience to self-realization, but it's not the experience of self-realization. Which is called Ananda Maya Kosha. It's Ananda, but it's Maya. It's an illusory Ananda. Kosha. Veil. Layer. Or it can be also quiet mind. See, this is Ananda Maya. It's illusory bliss. It's quiet mind. See, bliss is that which is aware of quiet mind. This is not Maya, Ananda Maya. That's real Ananda. I'll keep on trying. Let's see how far will I go. Let's see who succeeds, you or me. Right. Laughter. See, laughter. Laughter.
That's right, because when we laugh, we lost the mind.
Yeah, but then you get used to that, see. So, this is ecstasy. Ecstasy is not bliss. Ecstasy is, bliss is nothing. Bliss is unmanifested. See? It is your silence. It is alive, vibrantly alive, but it's not ecstasy. When the mind is merged completely in the self, what is the laughter? What is the giggle? What is the ecstasy? It is not. The ecstasy comes out of realizing the absurdity and then you laugh. See, the ecstasy comes, see, the mind comes out, see, completely wet of the bliss of the self. Right? It is okay, but then it dries up.
It's ego.
Yes? No, it's not ego. It's not ego. It's not ego. It can become ego, see? It can become the ego later on. So when Mikiko comes, see, the Mikiko, if you notice that Mikiko is coming, and Mikiko notices that we notice her, see, and if Mikiko notices that we notice her 100 meters before coming, for 100 meters, see, for that distance, then she will be coming. Right? And she will walk 100 meters. Yeah? And when she will sit here, she will still. No need to do it so many times. Not even true Japanese people do that. They just say. Otherwise, it's mechanic, see? It's mechanic and it's dry. We don't really mean it. See? How becomes diplomacy or something? Diplomatic ego. And as soon as you turn around, right, they stab you in your back. So it's not real, right? It's diplomatic. His mind, whether it's good or bad, is mind. Mind is good or bad. Mind is qualities, good qualities, what correct qualities, right? Am I right? It's called auspicious tendencies and non-auspicious tendencies. One leads to pain, the other one leads to pleasure. Right? Merits and demerits, right? Then? And when the mind is quiet, what is that? What is good and bad when the mind is quiet? Where are you? Who are you when the mind is quiet? And how are you? And how is the other? And who is the other when your mind is quiet? If your mind is quiet, there is no other, right? Much less the good and bad. That's like Shakespeare said that. Good and bad are concepts of the mind. Baba says, there is no good and bad in the world, it is only in your mind. What you think in the other is what you think about yourself. It's within yourself. You're projecting that. You're projecting one self, an individual self, and when you create this one self out of identity, then you create the other self, and then you create the qualities and the all that stuff. This is ego. Sometimes I remember the mandir was packed with people, thousands of people sitting there. Right? See? Brahmins there, holy people there, criminals sitting there also. No? He was looking at everybody. And treating everybody equally. And he was feeding the poor. You see, bad karma, this is why you are poor. See, no food for you. No, you see, whether you were poor or rich. See, this was treated equally. How many people there?
14.
Hmm? 9. Sorry?
7.
No questions? Hmm? So some food make you dal, see, some food make you rajasic, see. Some herbs also make you dal or rajasic. So whatever makes you dal or rajasic, it's better to stop it, right? Whatever makes you dal or rajasic, better to stop it. Right? When the mind is strong, that's a different story, but in the meantime, better to stop it, see. Like alcohol, cigarettes, marijuana, all that makes you dull. You need a clear mind. It's just a physical condition. The mind says, this physical condition is the best, it's better than any other physical condition. This is why I say, I like it. See? Why should I stop? I like it. Right? It doesn't affect me. I am the self. Right? Then you have an addiction, you don't even know it. You are controlled by an object, a herb. Right? And you don't even know it. Now, when you are super establishing your condition, do whatever you want, even though you will not do it because what's the point? I mean, you can, but when you realize the nature of what is the nature of the world, see, then you can play with it, right? In the meantime, just be careful. And if you're going to teach, you cannot even enjoy it because who's going to believe you, right? And the lighter being, what limitations can be for the lighter being? See, this is why Shiva was called the outlaw. See, outlaw. 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 See, no law could attach. He wasn't attached to any law. He could do whatever he wanted, right? Who is going to tell the self what to do or not to do, right? Now they say, how can I tell you, see, smoking a joint, telling you, don't smoke a joint, is not good for you, right? You won't believe me, right? It doesn't bother me, right? It doesn't affect me, right? But it affects you, right? And they say, how can I tell you don't smoke a joint if you do it? How can I tell you don't drink if I'm... And then this is the meaning of, see, when you are bound to teach, see, then you are, it's a sacrifice. You sacrifice your life, whatever it is there, for the sake of the others, right? And then you stop it. I can go with you to a bar. We can go together to a pub, see? And you and I can get pissed, see, completely drunk. Ah. Next day, you want to do it again. See? I'm not even think about it anymore, right? If not today, at least every weekend, right? And then you create a vicious circle. This is samsara, see? You want to repeat again and again the memories of what you like, and you want to avoid, see, the memories of what, see, good memories and bad memories. You want to repeat the good memories, and you want to avoid the bad memories. And then when I see you drinking, I say, you know what, I don't drink anymore. And I think you should stop too, it's not doing any good to you. So I can tell you that because I stop, otherwise I cannot tell you stop doing it, right? People were surprised why Baba was eating something called pan. It's a tulsi, it's a betel leaf. And then inside is a little bit of tobacco, a little bit of this and that. And he was chewing that. And he's supposed to give you a little bit of a high. And then he said to somebody, you have to stop chewing pan. And he said, you also chew pan? Okay, I give it up and you give it up. And it worked. And Baba says, I never had the addiction. I was waiting for him. I was doing it all this time, waiting for him to see. This is something that you have to have a very clear mind. Actually, you should have a no mind to understand all these things. See, Jesus was, there was, remember, there was a story in the Bible that Jesus was in a party. See, Jesus was invited to a wedding. You don't know that story? Jesus was invited to a wedding, right? And then the wine finished. Right? And they said, Master, the wine finished. Right? And he said, bring the water. See, put water in containers and bring them here. See, fill the jars with water. And turn into wine. See? But the next day he will say, hey, Peter, John, let's go and have a party again today. Let's have. No, see, it was not like that. Let's do it again. Woo-hoo! See, that was not Jesus, right? Not all the time, see? Now and then. Sorry?
Then it's important to have an external discipline?
For some time. For some time it is necessary.
Right?
What?
External discipline is to repeat every day the same thing.
No. See, for some people it's necessary. See, some people have to regularly do rituals, same balance, repeat mantras, meditate, and all that. For some people it's necessary, right? It's like you want to make a jewel. Right? Can you make the jewel? Without, how can you work with the gold without, you don't put it in the fire and it becomes a little bit softer, then you can do something about it, see, then you can bend it, right? See, so if the gold or the iron is too hard, how can you bend? You can't. So how can you look inside, see, with all these tendencies, all these desires to run after this and that, see? Some might have to be purified to a certain extent. Right? So you can turn the mind inwards. So all this. Now remember, self-inquiry, all the spiritual practices prescribed in all the spiritual books of all religion, all of them are contained in one practice called self-inquiry. All the austerities. See, if people knew how powerful it is to be quiet, see, they will be quiet all the time. Even Baba says, silence is the most powerful prayer. Sometimes he says, hands that work are more powerful than lips than prayer. But also he says, see, there is no more powerful prayer than silence. Quiet mind. It's a very powerful thing. Everything comes out of that. And everything happens as a byproduct of that. Ramana Tolthvanamalai Swami, see, one of his closest and most beautiful devotees. Stay here, don't move, don't ask anything to anyone, even to your neighbors. Remain as the self that you are, and whatever it is needed will come to you. See, silence. See, out of silence, everything comes. If you ignore the world, see, first, if there is ego, we are begging for things in the world, right? I want begging, oh world, give me this, give me that, right? Ignore the world, see, and the world comes to you, come, why do you ignore me? See, take it, take it, take it. Right? It's like a shadow, see? Like your own shade, right? You try to run after your shade, right? You try to catch the shade, you run after it, it runs in front of you, right? Try to jump on you, try to jump on your head. Yes? Right? I will conquer the world, right? And then you try to jump on the head of the shade, right? You jump on the shade moves, see? You jump on the shade moves. You will never succeed like that, right? Isn't it? Now turn around. See, turn around and walk away. And the shade is where? Behind you. See, it runs behind you, right? My teacher was not having breakfast. See, he was looking to Baba, and then suddenly an apple was on his lap. See, no, you haven't eaten your breakfast, so you must be hungry. See, and then what you need comes to you. You keep quiet, right? And it comes to you in one way or another. So you keep quiet. That's the best thing we can do. God will have to take care of you. You don't want anything. God says, my God, look at that. I better do something, otherwise this fellow is going to die. Let's bring something, right? Symbolically, he will come out of yourself. This is my experience, right? See? My wife left, see, took all the money away, right? I only have 500 rupees, 3 kurta pyjamas and self-knowledge. That's all. I didn't freak out, I just sat in my room. Only 500 rupees. After 3 days, 500 rupees gone. 3 days, see, 100 rupees went away. 500 rupees went away in 3 days. I needed to pay, I paid the electricity bill and something else, and the rest was for food. 3 days. And during these 3 days, a friend of mine was having a dream with Baba telling, hey, go to Caesar's house and give him this amount of money. Second day, hey, he said, I couldn't believe the dream. So I thought, well, if the dream is real, he has to appear again. Second day, hey, go to Caesar and give him this amount of money. Third day, hey, he's running out of money, go and do it. If you want something from the world, keep quiet. If you want something out of this world, which is this self-knowledge, then keep quiet. So whether it is this way or that way, you keep quiet. Right? You want to remember something? Keep quiet. Right? You want to forget something? Then keep quiet. Right? Where are my keys? Where are my keys? Keep quiet. And then, oh, I remember. See? You have a bad experience, you want to forget about it, then keep quiet. Stop thinking about it. I'm telling you, it works. See, I'm speaking everything that I say here, it's my own experience. See? And you know it already. Somebody asks a question that I don't know, I say, I'm sorry, I don't know. And I don't know. I don't know so many things, right? I don't even know how I know what I know. See, that much I know. The taxi guy is here. Last call cost 10 rupees. I haven't made any call to anyone. See? Yes, you can stop. See, the company.